deactivate the hover engines because I don't want you hovering. Deactivate the thrusters because I don't want you thrusting. And then power on. And why are you... But I what? Why are you... No! Come back here! No! All right, welcome back to Empyrion Galactic Survival. I'm KnowItAllDM. How's everybody doing today? I'm doing really good today. I apologize for the episode being a little later than normal today. I didn't have a chance yesterday to record because I was caught up in, well, watching Constantine. Anyway, it's a DC comic show that is recently been incorporated into the CW's DC verse, Arrow Flash verse thing. But anyway, I was watching that and I got caught up and didn't get a chance to record. So I'm recording this morning to get this out later today. So first thing I want to do, the barge here has been a little, it hasn't been maneuvering right. It's been trying to tilt over, probably because it's taller than it is wide. So I figured I would put a couple more hover engines on with some wings. Now, these wings, I'm going to extend. Let's see. I don't want it to cover up things as much, so I think I'm going to do like this. Let's see. How can I do this without making it hard to get into the barge? Let's see. If I... do this. And let's see. Hey, you're not supposed to be down there. Why was that down there? Maybe I needed this one. Yes, like that. And then... no matter what I do, it's going to make it difficult to get in from this side. Unless I make it where you get up onto the wing and then into... you know what I really ought to be doing? Something that I haven't done in the past, but I'm gonna go ahead and do that here. Let me make this side equal to this side. Okay, using these on the mirror thing is kind of wonky anyway. You like that, and the angle part is before, and then that goes there. Okay, like this. Okay, now, what I'm going to do, now that these are equal, let's YZ like so. And if you wonder how I did that, you have to have a block selected, something that you can add onto it. Then when you hold in and click, it will put the plane of symmetry wherever you put it. XY is the vertical plane, XZ is the horizontal plane, and Y or XY is the that plane there. So YZ is what we want to go along this symmetrical plane. That way, when I add blocks like so, it automatically adds them to the opposite side. So, now I want, I want to put the hover engine back here, like so. And then I want to make it look purely aesthetically like it's being held on, like so. I hate the new hover engine that it's a full block. I prefer having them be the flat things like the hover booster are now. But, you know, it is what it is. So now that I have that, I want to make this where I can get up here relatively easily. If it were completely flat, I would be able to just, you know, go straight up. All right, sorry about that. I had to sneeze, so I muted the mic. Okay, now that I've got the hover-y-ness, let me actually take this off and I will put... I'm going to put ramps going down there. So, did I build any ramps? I think I was making ramps. Let me get rid of that annoying plane. There we go. I did not make any ramps. Let's make some ramps. Four ramps is what I'm going to need. So let's get those started. So what I plan on doing today, apart from just fixing that, is I'm hoping that I can uncover the rest of the MS Titan, whichever part that was. Where is it? Over here. The back part. I'm going to dig out the bottom of the, like, the entire bottom of the back part and see what else I can get from inside there. But to do that, I'm going to take the hover vessel over, which is why I wanted to get it, squared away. So, I do like the design of this with the, cargo box, refrigerator, and the, constructor over there. All right, are you done? No, you've only done one. Well, that's great. So this is going to take a little bit of time for this to build up. So let me make sure that I've got fuel and stuff in here. Fuel, oxygen. Okay. I like the wing. It's, yeah, it flows with it like I planned. In fact, no, I'm going to leave that where I can put the ramp. I was going to see if I wanted to extend this out with another angle thing like that, but I'm going to be putting a ramp there, so no. While we're waiting for the ramps, let's take the hover vessel out and see if it maneuvers any better than it did. It should, now that I have the hover wings on it. Let's get it up. All right, 3 meters high. It it wants to angle a bit, but the hover engines on the sides seem to balance it out. Nice. Okay, so I could just come right on over here and start working if I wanted to. It looks like there's no more drones over here guarding this place. So I shouldn't have any problems with them to worry about. Let's get back over to the house and see if I can get a turret to put on this hover vessel just in case. Because I did learn the minigun turret for just that purpose. And I will put the minigun turret on top. Whoa! Left shift, pop up, keep on going. Is that a spider or an alien insect? I think that's an alien insect. Yes, that's an alien insect. Oh, now I'm out of... Drone to get... stuff. Right, and continue on back. Let's see, is that thing... I'll check that thing when I'm on my way back to see if it's... The hover booster doesn't seem to actually be doing anything at all, really. All right. Back up here. Let's power off. Now, are you done with all of those? Yes. Okay. Let's put the meat in here. Get a couple salamis. Let's put the rest of this stuff in here. And then that can go in here. I don't need the tier one drill anymore. Let me put you in here as a backup. And let me get you started working on... Hold on. Before I do that, let's make a minigun turret. And... 15 millimeter ammo, and then you can make these. Alright, I'm not going to need the turret right now. Also, if the turret's set on alien, it will attack the ship, because apparently they now have alien cores in them. And so I don't want that anyway. Alright, I want all of these... All of these. Yeah, you keep watering you, that's fine. Coffee will stay with me because everybody knows I love my coffee. Alright, once I get enough gardening supplies, I'm going to need a few more growing plots. I've got plenty of plants. I'm going to plant a garden. That'll probably be tomorrow's episode, planting the garden. Alright, I'm back. I don't know why my game crashed just then, but... Alright, let's put the symmetry plane on again. This way. And then putting you... Let me make sure that it does correctly over here as well. Yes. Alright, and then up here. Just fine. Okay. So let's take all this stuff up and take off the symmetry plane. None. Zero deaths! Yay! I'm hoping I don't die. I'm gonna try to not die. But, of course, everyone should always try to not die. Alright, let's head on over to the MS Titan and see what I can do about uncovering it a bit. And let's get a little higher, up to the 3 meter mark. I hear a plant creature, but I don't need to kill plant creatures anymore. Yeah, that booster doesn't do anything with just one pad, it seems. Well, okay, it doesn't do anything with just one pad with the amount of stuff I have on the thing. So I might have to increase my number of booster pads because of how heavy this is. Okay. Let's just sit down right here. All right. Alright, nothing bad around right now, so... Okay, to start digging out the MS Titan back part, we are going to need... Let's see... Where is the door on this side? There's supposed to be a door on... Oh, it's under there. It's under the ground. Because this is buried severely. Okay. So what I'm going to do, I already... started on this side here. Let's see. So, digging down here will uncover the door on this side. Now, I don't remember if there's crates down here or not, but I'm looking for the core so I can take out the core and then start disassembling things and get a lot of... lot of materials from it. Because disassembling the Titan is just about the only thing it's good for, unless you want to turn it into a base, which I have done on in other games. Turn the front part makes a great base for one person, the mid part as well. The back part only makes a really good base if you're going to have more than one person, because it's so big, it's pointless to turn the whole thing into a base. You could turn part of it into a base, like the little spire thing on the back, or one of these side things or something, and it'll be fine. And, of course, yeah, they haven't updated it, so it's just got whole cube gray instead of steel blocks still, so... Alright, let me zip through this real quick and get this side unburied, and then I'll be right back once I get this side unburied and start on the other side. So it looks like this is the entirety of this section here. The core is not in here. I figured it wouldn't be. My guess is that the core is in the center. Oh yeah, I can't even open the door because wrong core. So, I did empty out all these though, right? Okay. So the next thing that I want to clear out, I want to clear out this middle room, or middle section, because I know it's, I think it's got some, not out here, but I think up near the front it does. The core is more than likely in the center there, probably down there. So let's find out. I'm going to go ahead and clear out this other side, which, of course, I can't clear it out by going through that door. So let's get on up here and get in. If I could jump properly. All right. Up. There we go. And yeah, in through here. All right, now make sure I cleared out all of that, and there's one more over here. Yep, got all that. All right, let's start digging down through here. So I got this section almost completely dug out. Just got this little bit right here. And there we go. All right. So again, no core on this side. I didn't think it would be. But the next thing we've got to do is to dig out the middle area. Middle's this way. Out here, we've got to dig out underneath here. Now this is going to take a bit because you see how it's up in the mountain? So this whole area is going to be completely filled with terrain. And the only way to get in, since we can't access the doors, because there should be a door right down here, but we can't access the door there. Actually, I can go around the door. I wonder, is there a door on the other side? If there's not a door here, I can just come in here like normal. But I'm really curious to find out where that core is. So I'm going to dig this area out, and when I get to the core, I'll be back with you guys. So I found the core. If you guys are wondering, the core, once you come down into this room, you can come down through this elevator down to the room. This is the elevator that leads up to the little top shaft thing. And you can come out here, which is the forward of the ship. And all the way in the back, dig beyond this post. Up here, you'll see that not only is there a white block, which is weird, but the core is right above it. So I'm going to finish digging this out, and then I'm going to take the core out. But before I start disassembling anything, I want to try to replace it with my own core and then save the design so I can put it in creative mode and see what I can do with it in creative mode, see the entire construction of it. Now, they say that the Titan parts are, like, the if you were to assemble them, they would appear similar to the Talos, what do they call it? Talos Cruiser Mark II in creative mode. So what I want to do is spawn the three parts of the Titan into a creative mode and then bring the Talos Cruiser Mark II over to it and see just how similar they are, because apparently they were made by the same people. So I don't need to finish drilling out. I don't even know why I'm still drilling. Just something to do while talking. Okay, so I've got the four containers down here, which there's the four, the two over here and two over here that are always here. Okay, that had some useful stuff in it. I like that it gives you neodymium, because that means that you don't actually have to go to the moon to get neodymium. All right, let me take out this core. All right, so a full clip of a tier 2 pistol will let you take that out. Okay. So let's come over here. Now, let me deactivate. Let me group everything first. All right. Deactivate the hover engines because I don't want you hovering. Deactivate the thrusters because I don't want you thrusting. And then power on. And why are you... But I... What? Why are you... No! Come back here! No! No! Okay, that was completely unexpected. That's why I deactivated my hover engines and thrusters. Please come back here. Okay, I think it's not stopped moving yet. I might have to reactivate its thrusters just to get it to hold still. Okay, it's almost stopped. Why are you hovering? I told you not to hover. Maybe I have to deactivate the hover booster as well. Okay, it's basically stopped. Nope, because... Okay, yeah, you can't deactivate the hover booster. Okay, well, let me turn your thrusters back on. And apparently... Okay, apparently deactivating the hover engines doesn't do anything, or does it? Hover engines active? Deactive. It really doesn't seem to do anything at all, activating or deactivating the hover engines. So, okay, let's get you nice and snug right here. Alright. Let's turn your hover engines off. Not that it does anything. And the thrusters... off. And now you should just stay right here. Okay, what I wanted to do is put this stuff in here and build up a core to put in there. Alright, and if I just go all the way down, it should be fine. Okay. So, once that core gets built up, I will replace it and save the design. I'm actually surprised all I got was that stuff. And let me, while the core is crafting up, come up here and make sure that I got everything from in here. Okay, yeah, I just tried to see if I could save it without replacing the core, and you can't. Alright, give me this stuff, and that stuff. Okay, I don't know what that spoiled food was. Oh, yeah, that was, I think, like, aloe or a corn dog or something I placed in there so I could carry more things. Alright. So I've gotten all the cargo containers from... Come on. Let me... Fine, I can't jump up in there. Fine. There we go. I've gotten all the stuff out of all the cargo containers. And it's almost done with this core. Once I get the core in and save the thing, I'll head back home and call it a day. Come on. One. Make me a core. Brilliant. All right. Hop up here. Down to here. And... just for kicks, I'm going to place it in the exact same spot that it was, which is right there. Okay, now I should be able to save it. All right. Save as Crashed MS Titan Back P, because apparently the entire thing is... all right, got it saved. And I'm just going to leave my core in there if people want to blast the heck out of this thing. Actually, I'm going to go ahead and start disassembling some things. Let's see. Let me drill down here. Okay, the primary things... Actually, I'm not, yeah, I did just save it, so... The primary things that you want to disassemble when you are in the back part, you've got large thrusters over here. You've got small thrusters down here. These things give you decent computer parts and stuff. You may or may not want to disassemble the elevators. I tend to leave them because they really don't have, you know, it doesn't take a whole lot to build elevators. And then same up here. And on, I believe, the other side. Actually, I don't know. Somewhere there's supposed to be a thruster up here, but I don't. It might be out. I could have swore there was a thruster on each side in the back, which would be on the other side. Out here. But there's not one on this side. So, but the other side does have a thruster like that. Right. And then on the exterior there are some thrusters, small thrusters out there too. You also want to disassemble the RCS. The most reason you want to disassemble these things is they give you advanced CPUs. Which you need neodymium to make. If you don't find neodymium, you can disassemble those and get advanced CPUs. The only thing this place doesn't give you is stuff that you need to, like Sathium, which you can get in orbit, or Zascosium and Aristrium, which you can find on other planets, although there are You can get Zascosium and Aristerium from, whatchamacallit, the Talon Guardian Temple. You can get them, I think. I don't know where those other small things are, but the small thrusters, but I ain't gonna worry about it. I'm just gonna take you up. You were never up. Alright, let's you up. You up. Alright. Now. Let's activate the hover engines, which doesn't do anything at all, even power consumption wise, apparently. Activate the thrusters. Back on out from here. And head on across the water back home. Now, I don't think there's any drones that are going to come into the vicinity and tear the place apart. I might go back and take the core apart or something like that. But for now, I'm just going to leave it in as it is. This is noticeably more stable with the wings on it than it was before. Alright, let's stop by here real quick. Let's get across the water over here so I'm floating. And drone. Alright, pick that up and head up here since I've got the water generator up here. I don't need the one down there. And it does seem that that last drone attack was the last drone attack. Alright, power down. And I can't get those just yet. I need to make a little landing platform for this thing out front. Why are you powered down? Did you run out of fuel? Don't tell me you ran out of fuel. You ran out of fuel. How dare you run out of fuel on me like that? That's not very nice of you. All right, fine. Let me get some fuel and fuel you up. Okay. Now, soon I should be 10th level and I can get a larger fuel tank. And at the same time, I should be able to get the large fuel packs. But for now, I like going ahead and getting all those. Okay. Anyway. Alright, so let me finish getting all this stuff out. Alright. And just the last little bit in here, like so. All right. And all remaining this stuff will go in here. All right, well. That, my friends, is going to be it for this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you did, hit that like button for me. Like I said, next episode, we're probably going to do a couple of things. We're going to build a landing platform for my hover vessel, so it's not at a weird angle like that. And I might go back and get that core from the MS Titan, but probably not. What I'm hoping to do next episode is come out over to here and start clearing out the abandoned mine, which I don't think I'm going to make it a home, since this place is basically all I really need for a home. So I'm going to probably just disassemble the entire thing over there. Like, not disassemble it, but, you know, take apart all the important things and clear it out and all that. But anyway, hope you guys enjoyed the episode. If you want to see more Empyrion Galactic Survival, go ahead and subscribe. I'm KnowItAllDM, and as always, y'all have a good day now.